I'm Evangelist Gabriel Fernandez, and God has called and commissioned me to preach the good news of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friend, I encourage you as I share a message with you, and I pray for you today. Be in agreement. Connect in faith. Believe, and you shall receive in the name of Jesus. Those who trust in God shall never go hungry. Welcome, my dear friend, to another video brought to you by GFM United Prayer and Revival Ministry, the ministry that aims to take you to the house of the living God. It is so good to be with you today on another day that God has given us by His grace, and by the grace of God, we will make it through. It is so awesome to be here, right here in a place where we can pray, where we can seek God, and we can just press in and receive from God. We serve such a good God. We serve a gracious God. And I'm going to show you from two places in the scripture today that indeed He is a good God. And those who put their trust in Him shall never be the same again. Now we're going to take our reading from two places. And the first place is from the book of Psalms chapter 37 from verse 25 to verse 29. Hallelujah. It says, I have been young and now I am old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken or his children begging bread. He is ever lending generously, and his children become a blessing. Turn from evil and do good, so you shall dwell forever. For the Lord loves justice. He will not forsake his saints. They are preserved forever. But the children of the wicked shall be cut off. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell upon it forever. We serve such a good God. Now, I want to break this down bit by bit before we go on and I share the next one with you. But I trust, I know, I believe, just the same way that it filled me with joy as the Lord gave me these two scriptures, I know it is going to fill you with joy. And your life will go to another level even as we pray today. So, it starts out by saying, I have been young and now I am old. Yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, or his children begging for bread. The psalmist is saying, in his whole life, from when he was born, he has never seen a righteous man. And who is a righteous man? A righteous man is someone who puts their trust in the Lord, someone who comes to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. He has never seen a righteous man forsaken, or his children begging for bread. My dear friend, I want to tell you something. As you come to God through Jesus Christ our Lord, God will take care of all of your needs. As you put your trust in God and choose to live and walk in the way of God, God will take care of you. It goes on to say, He is ever lending generously, and His children become a blessing. When you walk in the principles of God, God will supply all that you need. These are the benefits of living a life that is genuine for God. These are the benefits of living a life where you are truly sold out to Jesus. God will supply all you need. As you follow the principles of God as laid out in the Word, you will never lack anything. You will never lack any good thing. It says, turn away from evil and do good. So shall you dwell forever. For the Lord loves justice. He will not forsake His saints. It's so essential, my dear friend, that daily we choose to pick up our cross and to follow the Lord. You know, some people may say, Evangelist, how can one walk a life that is blessed? How can one walk a life that is truly blessed of God? And the key and the answer is to follow God with all of your heart. It's so essential. If we want to walk in this realm where God takes care of us, it is so essential that we turn away from those things that the Holy Spirit tells us are wrong, and we choose to follow God. Sure, we all fall short of the glory, we all make mistakes, and we all need the grace of God to save us. But by the power of the Spirit, we can overcome. By the power of the Spirit, we can break free from all those bondages and chains. We can break free from everything that holds us back. Today, make a decision in your heart that you will follow God with all of your heart, and you will let that fire within you burn bright, that you will be a point of contact for God on this earth, that wherever you go, the presence of the living God will go with you, and God will touch the people around you wherever you go, because you have chosen to live in a way that pleases God. They are preserved forever, but the children of the wicked shall be cut off. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell upon it forever. The key and the answer is to follow God and to become sold out to Him. And when you make a mistake, don't be weighed down with guilt and condemnation. I'm not here to condemn you. I'm not here to weigh you down with guilt and condemnation. But I'm here to encourage you to go for Jesus with all of your heart. Simply turn back to God, and God will accept you with open arms and say, God, it's not easy, but help me. I'm willing. Help me to walk this way, in the way that you want me to go. And He will, my dear friend. He'll help you to walk this life. And He will empower you divinely to achieve that purpose and that destiny that He has apportioned to your life, to achieve that plan and that purpose that He has entrusted to you, so that you can walk in that gifting, so that you can live to the fullest in Christ, so that you can achieve great things. Now, the next scripture that the Lord gave me is from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, from verse 6 to verse 7. And I really love this scripture. Listen to this. It is so wonderful. It says, and He said to me, it is done. Wow. Hallelujah. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give from the spring of water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. Now let's break it down. It says, He said to me, it is done. Hallelujah. My dear friend, whatever you are trusting God for, as you put your trust and your hope in Him, as you are trusting Him and you are praying and you're saying, God, help me, the Lord says, it is done. It goes on to say, I am the Alpha and the Omega. It is Jesus speaking. The beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give from the spring of water of life without payment. I want to tell you something, my dear friend. There is something that all human beings have, and that is a longing for God. They are searching constantly what will satisfy them. They are searching and trying various different things, looking for something that will quench the inner thirst. But there is only one thing that can quench the inner thirst. There is only one person who has that, and His name is Jesus Christ. And that thing that can quench the inner thirst is the rivers of life, the water from the spring of life. Jesus will give it to you. And guess what? He'll give it to you without payment. That is the grace of God available in Christ. The one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. Now, this part is so important because it ties back in with the other verse I shared with you. The one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. The one who says, no matter what may come my way, no matter what may happen, no matter what comes my way, I will believe in Jesus. I will not give up on Jesus. I will not give up on God, because God won't give up on me. No matter what may happen, no matter how dark it may get in this world, I will not give up following Jesus. The one who presses through and overcomes will receive the prize. My dear friend, today I'm here to encourage you as we pray Friday financial prayers. Run this race in such a way so that you'll receive the prize. Run this race in such a way so that you will receive the glorious, victorious crown from Jesus. As a born-again believer, as a child of God, as a son of God, as a daughter of God, wherever you are, God is going to take you to a greater glory. As you choose to live in a way that pleases God, you will see God release the grace over your life so that you will accomplish great things, so that in the midst of drought, you will still go up, so that in the times when everyone is going down, people will look at you and they'll say, wow, this can only be God. How are you still making progress in a time when everyone is going backwards? Even in times like that, you will go up. But there is one key. There is one principle. There is one thing that we need to do. We need to follow the Spirit of the living God. We need to take the Word of God. I have my Bible here. I have an electronic Bible and I have a physical one over here. And it's always essential to have the physical one on hand, because you never know when the electronic one will die. But this is our Word. Take the Word of God. Make it the standard for your life. and choose from today that you will burn with such a fire for God like never before, and you will see how God will come through for you. Now, in saying that, my dear friend, I discern the presence of God. Let us go into a time when we begin to praise God, and even as we go deeper, then we'll begin to pray, and I trust, I know, I believe God will bless you. So in saying that, begin to praise Him in your own words. Father, you are our God, and we just praise you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. Thank you, Lord, for another day that you've given us today, another day that we can live to the fullest. Thank you, Father, that we have made it through another week. It doesn't matter what may be happening in the world right now. We will not give up on you because you don't give up on us. We will not give up following you, but we will continue following you until the very end. I praise you and I thank you that both myself and my dear friend can pray today, that both myself and my dear friend can seek you today, and we can press in and receive the prize. Even as today is Friday and we pray Friday financial prayers, I thank you and I know that you will supply all that my dear friend needs according to your glorious riches in Christ. Do what only you can do, and even as you do it, receive all the praise, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. My dear friend, I discern the presence of God, and I know like I know, as we pray today, God is going to bless you. Now, we're going to go into a time of prayer, and even as we go into a time of prayer, I want to encourage you to do two simple things. The first thing that I want you to do, my dear friend, is just lift up your hands and just welcome the Holy Spirit. Say this out loud. Say, Holy Spirit of God, I welcome you. Come, Lord Holy Spirit. Come and take over control. Do what only you can do, Lord. Lead me closer to Jesus. Help me to live this life in such a way that I will fall into the categories that were mentioned in the scripture that was read today. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. My dear friend, the second thing that I want to encourage you to do is to comment down below in the comment section and agree with me. There is so much power and agreement, and even as you comment and agree, God is going to bless you. But in saying that, let us begin to pray. Father, I pray for my dear friend. Right now, wherever my dear friend is watching, and whatever the situation might be, I thank you there is no situation that is too big for you. I thank you that there is no situation that you can't change. There is no distance that you can't go. There is no problem that you can't solve. So even as we pray today and we are trusting you, begin to do what only you can do. Right now, release the grace over my dear friend, that my dear friend will go for you with all of their heart, that my dear friend will be so on fire for you, because it is all about Jesus. It is not about us. We are not trying to build our own kingdom. We already have a kingdom. It is the kingdom of Jesus Christ, and we are part of it as one body in Christ, all functioning in our different functions and doing what we need to do, because now is such a time that you require people to worship you in spirit and in truth. And we choose from today onwards to worship you in such a way. Release the grace over my dear friend, that my dear friend will be a genuine son, that my dear friend will be a genuine daughter of yours, following you with all of their heart and committed and sold out to you beyond a shadow of a doubt, that nothing will be able to change the situation. Nothing will be able to change their mind. Nothing will be able to stop them from following you. That nothing will be able to stop them from going for you with all of their hearts. I pray this in Jesus' name, and I thank you for it, Lord. Amen. Right now, Father, I pray, release the grace over my dear friend, that my dear friend will prosper financially and even physically, as my dear friend commits to living a life that gives you glory. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. My dear friend, you are blessed and you cannot be cursed. As you choose to follow God, may these scriptures be fulfilled in your life. May you see the blessing of the Lord, and may you go up no matter what. No matter what the devil tries to do, may you go up. No matter what he tries, may he watch and see as you go up whether he likes it or not. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I apply the blood of Jesus over you, and I decree and declare this deliverance is permanent in the name of Jesus. Until next time, shalom and goodbye.
In saying that, my dear friend, we come to the end of this video. If you are blessed by this video and you feel led to donate or to partner with us to support us in this work that we are doing, then you can do so through PayPal or Patreon. All the links are provided in the description. Until next time, God bless you and goodbye.